Well, dozens of San Diegans gathered this afternoon to protest a deal that would lock San Diego City into a 20-year deal with SDG&E. And Fox 5's Jamie Chambers, he joins us now from City Hall with why some say this is a bad deal, Jamie.
Yeah, they've been absolutely battling over this for quite some time. Now, the mayor and the city council will be meeting on making a decision on this new franchise contract with the folks. But they're also battling, SDG&E is also battling with solar companies. And SDG&E is once again entangled with the solar companies over net metering rules, which are expected to be altered sometime later this year. And net metering is the ability for solar owners to charge SDG&E for the power that their solar panels are generating from the grid to the grid. Now, SDG&E says solar owners are able to offset their personal costs, forcing lower and middle class families to pay more for power lines and updates to the grid. Solar companies say SDG&E is trying to make solar production less affordable and forwarding the use of fossil fuels. San Diego attorney Mike Aguirre says SDG&E and other solar companies are fighting to remain powerful as solar starts to make a big impact.
We could literally be in a situation where folks are able to support their cars with solar power, electric cars, heat their homes, maintain all the electricity they need, and not really have to go through the utilities at all. And that's right now, the Public Utilities Commission has shifted from being a regulator of the utilities to a protector of the utilities.
So it's a big question mark for the future of solar. There is a lot at stake in these negotiations. Also, it's a big question mark for the future of San Diego's power system, whether this franchise deal will move forward. That will be decided tomorrow at 11 o'clock. The solar debate starts on Wednesday. That's the very latest from downtown. Jamie Chambers, Fox 5 News.
There's just one more day before the city council votes on a franchise agreement with SDG&E, and not everybody is singing its praises. A group gathered outside San Diego City Hall this afternoon to urge council members to vote no on the proposed deal with SDG&E. The utility company has agreed to pay $80 million from shareholder funds to the city. It also has agreed to dole out $20 million for climate equity goals. And those will be in $5 million allotments over 4 years that SDG&E will pay no later than 2037. But critics say that's not fast enough nor enough.
Lower rates is what we require. And addressing our climate, our equity, and needs for San Diegans need to start today, not 16 years later in 2037.
The proposed deal needs 6 yes votes to pass tomorrow.